This video is sponsored by Granite Studio, RKDF University. Good morning, I'm Tushya Agarwal and you're watching News Flash. Today is the 24th of June and we have a lineup of crucial stories touching every corner of the globe. From the latest developments in politics to groundbreaking advancements in technology. Days after Louisiana became the first US state to mandate the display of the 10 commandments in public schools, former President Donald Trump praised the decision and endorsed the idea. Speaking to a group of evangelicals, Trump emphasized that influential evangelicals cannot afford to sit on the sidelines in the upcoming 2024 presidential elections. External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar is travelling to the United Arab Emirates on Sunday to hold wide-ranging talks with his counterpart Abdullah bin Zayed Al Nahyan. Now, besides bilateral issues, Jaishankar and Al Nahyan are expected to deliberate on the overall situation in Gaza. A French woman, Laurence Van Wassenhove, has filed a lawsuit against telecommunications giant Orange, claiming she was paid a full salary for 2 decades without being assigned any work. Now, Van Wassenhove alleges that Orange sidelined her after she requested a transfer due to her disability, leading to this unusual legal battle. Nigeria is planning to send its first citizen to space. According to Matthew Adepto-Poju, the Director General of Nigeria's National Space Research and Development Agency. The announcement was made during a press conference in Abuja, as reported by the Nigerian news outlet Premium Times. This marks a significant step in Nigeria's space exploration efforts. Iran smuggled 2 Airbus A340 aircraft originally leased by Gambian company Maka Invest that were flying from Lithuania and intended for Sri Lanka and the Philippines. Instead, these planes ended up in Iran, raising significant concerns among Lithuanian authorities. Encounters with terrorists in Jammu and Kashmir have resulted in the seizure of highly encrypted Chinese telecom gear known as UltraSet, typically used by the Pakistani army, but now found with terror groups officially said. Now, this raises concerns about undetected infiltrations from across the line of control and the possibility of terrorists residing in the outskirts of cities and the villages. A second mayor in southern Mexico has been killed within a week, local authorities announced on Saturday. Acacio Flores, the mayor of Melianapeltic, was murdered during a visit to an indigenous community. This follows the recent killing of Salvador Villalba Flores, another Guerrero state mayor elected in the June 2 polls. A merchant ship was damaged by a drone attack in the Red Sea near Yemen early on Sunday morning, though no injuries were reported, according to a British maritime security agency. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. said on Sunday his country is not in the business of instigating wars and will always aim to settle disputes peacefully amid escalating maritime confrontations with China. A nuclear-powered US aircraft carrier arrived on Saturday in South Korea for a three-way exercise involving Japan as they set up military training to cope with North Korean threats, which have escalated following a security pact with Russia. It is time for a break now. We'll be back with more news. Stay tuned.
इस तरह RKDF विश्वविद्यालय राज्य और देश के आधुनिक और उच्च विश्वविद्यालयों में से एक है। RKDF University, a world-class university. Education glorifies nation.
The ministry offices in Luton's Delhi, Hotel Janapath, as well as airport terminals. Granite Studio India, with its prestigious brands, rich experience, and the trust of our clients, can be your reliable partner. We are here for you, for innovating, processing, supplying, and executing in stone. Contact us today for our special sample kit.
A senior UK minister has likened the current election betting scandal to a Partygate scandal amid reports of another Conservative Party official facing police investigation. Now, Nick Mason, the Chief Data Officer of the Conservative Party, is allegedly being investigated by the Gambling Commission for placing bets on the date of the upcoming general election before it was officially announced. At least 39 people have been killed in Israeli airstrikes on 4 neighborhoods in Gaza City, Palestinian officials reported. Rescue operations are ongoing to find survivors trapped in the rubble, with rescue groups warning that the death toll is likely to rise. As part of its stepped-up hostilities, Russia bombed a residential building in Kharkiv in northern Ukraine on Saturday, leaving 3 people dead and almost 30 wounded. Volodymyr Zelensky, the president of Ukraine, shared pictures of an apartment building's damaged front and an open pit outside. Security forces have seized a significant cache of fake currency notes and printing equipment linked to Naxalites in Chhattisgarh's Sukma district, as senior police official reported on Sunday. Now, Naxalites allegedly used these counterfeit notes in weekly markets in the Bastar region to deceive innocent tribals. The Indian Space Research Organization hit another milestone on Sunday after successfully conducting the third and final reusable launch vehicle landing experiment. This was the third and final test in the series of Flex-03 and was conducted at 710 IST at the Aeronautical Test Range in Chitradurga, Karnataka. The GST Council on Saturday adjusted tax rates on various items including student accommodation services and solar cookers. Now, additionally, it introduced taxpayer-friendly measures such as waiving interest and penalties for demand notices issued during the first 3 years of GST implementation. At least 7 people were killed and 100 kidnapped on Saturday night when gunmen attacked a rural community in Nigeria's northwestern Katsina State, residents and police reported on Sunday. This is the latest in a series of attacks by armed gangs, known locally as bandits, who frequently raid communities in the northwest, targeting residents, students and motorists for ransom. On Sunday, 4 members of the Hinduja family, the wealthiest in Britain, declared they had never been imprisoned, found guilty, sentenced or otherwise detained. Prakash Hinduja, 78, his spouse Kamal Hinduja, 75, their son Ajay, 56, and his spouse Namrata, 50, faced charges of usury for allegedly exploiting vulnerable immigrant employees by paying them meager salaries. The newly elected members of the 18th Lok Sabha will take their oaths of office today, June 24. The election for the Lok Sabha Speaker is set for June 26, followed by President Draupadi Murmu's address to a joint session of both the houses on June 27. However, the proceedings may be overshadowed by the controversy surrounding Bhartruhari Mehtab, a 7-term BJP member, being named pro-term speaker. External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar arrived in the UAE on Sunday for extensive talks with his counterpart Abdullah bin Zayed Al Nahyan. Before the meeting, Jaishankar visited the iconic Babs Hindu Mandir in Abu Dhabi and participated in the 10th International Yoga Day celebrations. A Central Bureau of Investigation team probing the UGC NET exam case was heckled in Bihar on Sunday. The CBI is investigating the question paper leak and other irregularities related to the UGC NET exam. Earlier this week, the center cancelled the UGC NET exam after discovering that the paper has been leaked and was circulating on Telegram. Two commandos from the CRPF's Cobra unit were killed in a Naxalite attack on Sunday in Chhattisgarh's Sukma district. Now, the commandos died in an improvised explosive device explosion in Timapuram village, situated between the Silgar and Tekal Gudem security camps. The blast occurred around 3 pm. That's all for the headlines of the day. For more updates, download the app and keep watching Rhythm.